But could you actually see yourself training full time eventually?
You know what? I can. I could. Yeah. Because you know what? Despite what some people think that I'm too rough on these young guys, let me tell you something. I don't treat them no different than I treat anybody else in the ring. You know, and the thing is, what did I do to Matt Cappotelli that was so bad? He got a fat lip and a bloody nose. I can't tell you countless times that I've had the fat lip and the bloody nose, and I never wanted to quit. I mean, for God's sakes, I've cracked my vertebrae against Brock. I kept wrestling. I broke my arm completely in two, kept wrestling. Mae Young goes through a table and gets the crap kicked out of her, and she keeps wrestling. So, and people want to jump on me for what I did to Matt Cappotelli. That's kind of silly if you ask me. Wrestling is a rough business. And I've never done anything to anybody that's bad to where they miss out, you know, or they're out from wrestling. You know, I wrestle nobody no different than the new guys. But the thing with me is I strive to get the best out of somebody. And when I train, because I love training people, I love helping people, you know, especially when I know that there's something there, you know, so. And the whole thing with Matt Cappotelli, you know, I was pretty much dictated to go in there and see what he's made of, just like I was dictated to do a lot of guys. And so, but yeah, as far as training young talent, I love helping them guys, you know, and I want to pull the best out of them and see what they can do. And, you know, yeah, I'm hard on people, but also I'm good to them in the same aspect, you know, so, and that's because I want them to be the best they can be, because when they get to that level of WWE, you've got to be good, you know, and that's why I want to help these guys become better. So when they do get to WWE, you know, they got a chance to go all the way to the top.